everyone, and welcome to our new episode of the Three Whiskateers, the show that likes to share a whiskey and have a lot of fun. Now, I'm Jamie, I'm your host. This is our angel-haired hipster, Curtis. His son, Bern, is behind the camera, and we have our happy on Durinetti.
I'm very tickled right now.
And, Curtis, I took a sneak peek.
Of course you did.
And this is kind of something people have been talking about. It's been all over. I've seen it on the Facebook pages that I follow. Iowa Whiskey Chasers have been talking about this, too.
Right.
Very so, cool page.
Group. Let's, no further ado, let's pop that open and let's talk about this.
Bam. What is it? Bam. 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 Boom.
This is light whiskey.
This is light whiskey. What is light whiskey?
Okay, well, back in the early 70s, the bourbon producers were trying to figure out a way to compete with vodka.
Whoa.
Okay.
That's kind of distinctive.
So they took their bourbon and they kept distilling it, just like you do with vodka. It became, the more higher alcohol, the less and less taste you have.
Mm-hmm.
Okay? So, it usually brought it up to, I believe, it had to be over 170 to 190 proof.
Okay? Wow.
190 proof. And then they would take this, and they would put it in a barrel for a very short time, so it would be very light. It would be almost like a vodka. Because there would be very little of the barrel flavor, very little of the whiskey flavor in it. And their idea was that they were going to use this, and they were going to make it so people would start drinking more bourbon because it'd be more like vodka.
Okay. So this is more like a green whiskey.
Oh, no, no. This one isn't. No, no.
Okay.
And that one really wasn't either, because that would have been more like a vodka than it's still a grain spirit, okay?
Okay.
Okay, still a grain spirit, but it'd be more like a vodka. So, what happened is that it completely failed.
Oh, okay.
I'm
sad.
Completely failed, and it didn't go anywhere. So, what happened was they realized that this style of whiskey is very good for blending whiskeys.
Oh.
So, a lot of the American and a lot of Canadian whiskeys were made with this.
Mm.
Okay, so Midwest grain producers, which is huge, Lawrenceburg, Indiana, they produce a massive amount of whiskeys.
Okay,
a lot of the whiskeys that are up here are produced there.
The alcohol in it,
yeah, the alcohol, yeah.
We've talked about that before.
Yeah, we've talked about that before.
So the alcohol and sometimes the whiskey also.
Oh, always the whiskey. They make the whiskey and then they put it in barrels. And then once it's matured to whatever the customer wants, then they
send it
to them.
So they do both. Okay.
Yeah, they do both. In this case, this whiskey is one of those light whiskeys, so it's a high alcohol content.
Okay.
And it instead of selling it to somebody who is going to mix it,
mm-hmm.
Eugene at a Cat's Eye Distillery down in Bettendorf, Iowa.
Mm.
He got it, and he made a special barrel release, and they're going to do several of these with a whole bunch of different styles.
Really?
Next one coming out in our area will be a real Dickels.
Okay.
Okay, which is going to be really good.
So I have a question.
Okay.
So the stuff from the 1970s is a little bit different than this, right? Because this is probably, they put a little more craft into this.
Well, no, actually what they did with this particular one is they put it in the barrel thinking they were going to sell it, I believe, to Seagram's.
Okay.
See, and then it got lost in the warehouse, apparently, and it sat there for 13 years.
Oh, shoot.
So, it matured very nicely in 13 years. And that's what we got right there, is what this light whiskey, high alcohol content, accidentally put into barrels for 13 years.
So, this is like a Bob Ross painting. It has happy little accidents. That's how we got this bottle.
Okay.
Do you remember when he did that with his paintings?
He's from the 70s, too.
Yeah.
Okay.
This is, oh my gosh. People are talking about this.
I was really surprised. I've never had a light whiskey. This is my first light whiskey. I was really surprised. The intensity of the flavors, you would think when in the old days they were trying to get away from that intensity. But sitting there for 13 years, this has really gotten an intense flavor.
Yeah.
But, and then the other thing is, I thought this high of an alcohol content, it's going to have a huge kick, and the flavors are going to be overpowered by the alcohol. But it's not. It has a sweetness. Not like a candy sweetness, but it has a caramelness, marshmallowy, caramel, yummy, gooey sweetness with all the flavors that you expect in what a really well-made whiskey.
Yeah, this is really good. When you to the nose, you can definitely tell it's high octane.
Yeah, there's some octane in there, but
when it makes my lips pucker. But the flavor is very explosive, but it's got that little, what I describe as a twang, where when something's aged for a while, it just makes your mouth pucker, and it's just, I don't know, it just makes me pucker. I don't know. This is a great combination. I am a fan of this thing.
You know what this does? It makes you, with the high alcohol, it's going to force you to go slow.
Yeah.
And take your time with it.
Oh, my gosh, yes. And you know what? You're going to enjoy it because that flavor,
because you know that it's going to be high alcohol and you don't want to go fast with this or be aggressive drinking. You want to go slow and take your time, and then you get to enjoy the flavors that are with
it. You're not like drinking straight, you know, White Lightning at 190 that has nothing in it at all, no flavor, no nothing.
Mm-hmm.
There is a flavor profile in here that is, I think, comparable to some of the best bourbons I've had, even though this is definitely not a bourbon because it doesn't fit in the bourbon category at all. Alcohol content. Mm-hmm. I'm going to be looking for more of these.
Yes, me too.
I mean, I haven't seen them.
What's the price point on something like this?
I think 65.
65, okay. I think it's worth it because the octane on it, I mean, if you want to get started, this will be one, you know, like for your night. And then just take it easy. Maybe get some Irish whiskey or something. After that.
You guys got anything else you want to add to this?
Again, Cat's Eye, they are the ones who are acquiring the bottles. Cat's Eye is the distillery
down there.
Bettendorf, right? They got, okay.
John is the distiller down there.
Okay.
Okay. And Eugene is the gentleman who is working with him, going out and finding these barrels. Like he's found some Dickels barrels from the old Dickels. And he's going to be releasing a bottle here in Iowa that is old Dickels.
Well, we would definitely do more on light whiskeys again, because this is very enjoyable.
Burn anything?
Stuff.
It's incredibly hot, but it's very good.
There you go.
Yeah, that's all I can think of. I mean, with as high an alcohol content as it is, I was expecting it to not have the sweetness that it does. Because typically,
you would think that it wouldn't, but it has an incredible.
Yeah, I thought it was going to be bitter too. I thought it was going to be bitter, and it wasn't.
Typically, the sugar burns, or the sweetness and sugar burns away with the higher alcohol content, but that's not the case with this. And it enters the mouth incredibly warm, and it goes down incredibly warm.
Mm-hmm.
It's a really unique drinking experience, that's for sure.
I hope we see a lot more light whiskeys.
Yeah.
I don't know that we will, but I hope we do.
You know, the name is a little deceptive. You need to learn the history to understand what it means.
Not a lot about this.
Because there's no light. It's very dark. The flavor is intense and
strong. Yeah, in this light whiskey, it really is.
Put your lights out, bro.
And they are keeping the same label with different colors for all of their releases, and they're going to be doing single barrel releases. Well, everything is single barrel releases from him. For example, this is bottle 152 of a total of 191 bottles.
Mm-hmm.
That's it.
That's it.
Yeah,
that's
I mean, if you look, 95%
corn.
So, with that, we need to ask everybody to hit the subscribe button, which is located right there. Bam.
Bam.
That's our call to action for Burn to signal us out.
All for one.
One for all.
It's hot.